The angel of the Lord brought tidings to Mary.
She shall conceive by the Holy Spirit.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, rejoice thou sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold, the handmaid of the Lord.
Be hailed to thee according to thy word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, rejoice thou sinners now and at the hour of our death.
And the word was made flesh.
And the word was born.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, the Holy Mother of God. Let us pray. Oh, for what we beseech, O Lord, the gracious of our hearts, that we, through the incarnation of Christ your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah. The word of the Lord was addressed to me, saying, "Before I formed you in the womb, I knew you. Before you came to birth, I consecrated you. I have appointed you as prophet to the nations." I said, "Ah, Lord, look, I do not know how to speak. I am a child. But the Lord replied, do not say, I am a child. Go now to those to whom I send you, and say whatever I command you. Do not be afraid of them, for I am with you to protect you. It is the Lord who speaks. Then the Lord put out his hand and touched my mouth, and said to me, there, I am putting my words into your mouth. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news.
Go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news.
Oh, praise the Lord, all you nations. Acclaim him, all you peoples.
Go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news.
Strong is his love for us. He is faithful forever.
Go out to the whole world, proclaim the good news.
Bishops, priests, and teachers, and all who speak in the name of the Church, that they may lead us into the deeper understanding of the teaching of Christ, which is required by the needs of our times. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our public representatives at home and abroad, that they may be an example of Christian living to all whom they meet and with whom they work. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For those who strive to bring our people together, whatever their race or creed, that by the power of Christ they may heal the wounds of fear and history. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayers.
For our own local community, that we may give witness to our faith by our kindness to those who need our help, the old and the young, the sick and the lonely, and those who are deprived in any way. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here to honour St. Patrick, that our love for our country may arouse in us a stronger commitment to Christ and to his gospel, which our forefathers have handed down to us. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
On our Father, hear the prayers of your people. Guide us on our way to you, inspired by Patrick. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God, all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, the work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. With humble spirit and contrite heart, may we be accepted by you, O Lord, and may our sacrifice in your sight this day be pleasing to you, Lord. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty God.
May the Lord accept
the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church. Lord, accept this pure sacrifice, which, through the labours of St. Patrick, your grateful people make to the glory of your name, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We pray the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for as on the festival of St. Patrick you bade your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we attain.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts of prayer by sending down your spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." We may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Mark, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, as well as with the Blessed Apostles, with St. Patrick, whose feast we keep today, and all the saints who have preached you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
David's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to sing.
Our God, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the Son of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
I'm not worthy.
Strengthen us, O Lord, by the sacrament, so that we may profess the faith bought by St. Patrick and proclaim by our way of living, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. Amen. Abide with your servants, O Lord, who implore the help of your grace, that they may receive from you the support and guidance of your protection, through Christ our Lord.